In today's video, we are going to take a look at BitLocker and other encryption that Windows uses and it provides, and how to unlock it without a password. So it is a very useful technique and it is usually used in forensic investigation. So BitLocker is something that encrypts the data in the hard disk. So whenever the hard disk is unplugged from the computer and plugged in another computer, the hard disk cannot be opened or the data cannot be retrieved. BitLocker is basically like encrypting your hard disk so that once it is unplugged, it cannot be used in any other computer without the key. Now, BitLocker is used in conjunction with a hardware component called TRM, that is Trusted Platform Module. TRM is like a smart card and it is present on the motherboard that stores recovery keys. So BitLocker requires TRM version 1.2 and higher. Right now I am using a virtual system and also known as virtual box to demonstrate how to use the software, how to unlock a BitLocker encrypted hard drive or pen drive, and how you can work around and how forensic investigators conduct their forensic investigation on BitLocked devices or hard drives. So for example, let's start, and I have just plugged in a hard drive, an extra hard disk, for the demonstration purpose. So let's try to learn how you can encrypt the device and how Bitcoin works. So before that, I will create a new partition in which I will add few files in the partition and encrypt the partition. So let's create a new partition. I'll create a simple new volume, and as you can see, the volume or the disk drive is created, and let's paste some simple data. So for example, we will paste some sample music that is provided inside Windows. So I will just copy them and paste it inside the new volume, and now this is the data that we want to retrieve. So for example, let's rename the disk as BitLocker and let's encrypt it. For example, if the user tries to encrypt it, there are three options to encrypt the data. The first one is via a password, then you can use a smart card, that is TRP feature, and you can automatically select and unlock the drive on this computer. Usually you have to enter a password and this is what we'll do. You can also use a smart card, but since we are on virtual system, we don't have the TRM feature yet. So we'll just enter a password. I will just enter a random password, click on next, and the encryption will start. So it takes some time to encrypt, and since we have a smaller amount of data in the hard disk, it will be faster. So after encryption, you have to save the key. You can either save it to a USB or you can save it to a file. In case if you forget the password, these keys are used to recover the password and decrypt the data. So as you can see, there are some keys available, and this file is very important to decrypt the BitLocked device or drive. So as you can see, encryption has started, and we are going to use a software that actually extracts the data from the memory. So we don't need that file to decrypt the data. You can actually use the software to encrypt and decrypt data from the files, and it actually supports VeraCrypt and various other decryption like Filevault 2 and PGP, TrueCrypt and various other hardware decryption. So there are tons of decryption available. It actually extracts the key from the RAM and it actually works and tries to dump memory, and there are various features. There are tons of features, and it is the best forensic tool. This is the best forensic disk decryptor tool that I have ever seen. So you need to download the setup. So once you purchase the software, yes, it is a paid software and you have to purchase it. So once you purchase the software, you have to install it, and you will be given a download link with a license key, a product key for the product. By the way, if you are interested into forensic, then I would suggest you to check the link provided in the description for more details about the product. For now, let me just install the product. So as you can see, the setup is downloaded in the downloads folder. I will click on run. I will click on next. Let's click on accept. And over here, you have to enter the purchase license code. After which you will be presented with a screen that allows you to install it. So as you can see, I've installed the software and there are tons of features including dumping memory and analyzing the memory. They are the expert and the best developers and they develop the best tools that are used by forensic investigator. So there are various options available. I will guide you through all the options. So for example, you can create a portable version, you can decrypt a drive, which is the last step actually. So as you can see, you can actually decrypt a physical drive which is present on the computer, physical disk or hard disk or physical partition. Basically, you can also decrypt an image. So as you can see, this was the one that was encrypted, and you can actually select a memory dump, you can select a saved key, you can select password file and various other things. We'll take a look at all these options in a bit, but for now let's just take a look at all the features that are available in the software. So it actually tries to get the passwords from the memory dump and even the password file. So you can also use an image. So most forensic investigators create an image of victim's computer or victim's hard disk, so you can use it. You can also use various mining tools, so these tools will provide keys from memory dump. I will also show you how you can create and find the keys from the memory. And the third option is to extract the data using various password recovery tools that they provide. So you can actually save the BitLocker volume into a file which can be later used to recover passwords. So as you can see, I will just save it as a test file. So step one is to dump the memory. So why is dumping a memory useful? So usually all the softwares store something in the RAM, and thus the BitLocker also stores something in the RAM, and that is the recovery key. So you can save the memory dump, you can create the memory dump and save it. And there are various other softwares available in the market which store memory dump, but this is the best that I have ever seen because it is faster, and all the other dump creators or memory dumpers take long time. So next step is to extract the keys from the dump. You can either directly decrypt the file or the disk using the memory dump, or you can extract the keys first. So in this case, we'll be extracting the keys just to show you, just to demonstrate how the key extraction works. So you just have to select a memory dump and it will start working on its own. So the software is something that works on its own and has all the features that are required to unlock a BitLocker disk drive or even various other encryption drive and disks. So, and it also has features that work along with other software. So for example, if you have an image of the partition, if you have an image of the victim's drive, you can do that. So as you can see, the keys are created and you can actually see various keys, PGP keys and various other keys. So you can select all and you can save the keys, you can extract the keys from memory dump. So if you have a tool that creates memory dump, then you can actually extract the keys from the memory dump. If you have memory dumps, you can directly decrypt them, or you can use the saved keys to decrypt. So for example, there are various options available to decrypt a disk. So as you can see, I will select the key file. As I have the key file, you can also select a memory dump. And now it's time to select the decrypted disk. You can either select it as a file or you can mount it directly. So this makes it simple. I will just mount the decrypted disk and I will click on mount, click on allow access, and this will mount the disk. So let's move on to my computer. And as you can see, this is the encrypted and this is the decrypted, and we have all the decrypted data as well. in a separate mounted disk drive. So this is how it works. It's an awesome software. So this is an all-in-one tool, and they also make various forensic investigation tools that will help you to work around with your investigation. So if you are a forensic investigator, then I would suggest you to visit their website and take a look at their website and all the products that they provide. So all the best, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. Hit the like button if you like the video.